It's 2022 and you're ready to learn a new skill. Maybe this is for a new job or job promotion. What better way to learn your first or maybe just another programming language? I can guarantee when you are about to learn a new programming language, whether you have learned tons in the past or this is your first one, one of the first challenges that you are going to come across right off the bat is, well, what programming language do I learn? There are so many out there, so many to choose from. Which one is right for me? Hey friends, welcome back to my channel. Today, we are going to be talking about the top programming languages to learn in 2022. These are based on the top job postings on LinkedIn from both Europe and USA. So whatever job postings were requiring the number one programming language, the number two programming language, that is what we are going to cover today. Before we get into it though, make sure to hit that subscribe button for more tech and coding related content. Give this video a thumbs up and don't forget to leave in the comments other videos you want to see. That's how I make these videos. So leave in comments what you want to see. Okay, let's get right to it. Okay, we're here again with my trusty whiteboard. You can see I live in Canada, so it's not even 5 p.m. and it's already getting a little dark outside. But we got this, we got this. Okay, coming in at number five for the top most popular programming languages is C sharp. And for a little fun fact about C sharp, the first time Microsoft used the name C sharp was back in 1988. Let's go talk more about it.
C sharp is an object-oriented programming language that is commonly used with Microsoft's .NET framework. Many of the advantages and features of C sharp are tied closely to .NET, which is why they team really well together. So why should you learn C sharp? Well, to start off with, it's a very useful and flexible language with a very expressive syntax that usually makes it pretty easy to pick up. Not to mention, if you are familiar with C, C++, or Java, you should be able to pick up this language relatively quickly. That being said, if it's your first programming language, don't worry, don't fret. It still will be pretty simple to pick up as long as you stick with it, read the documentation, do some tutorials, and keep on going. What can you build with C sharp, I'm sure, is the next question. Well, pretty much anything, whether it's business applications, games, web apps, mobile tablet apps, and so much more. For example, video games is something that C sharp is commonly used to create. This is because C sharp can quickly develop games for both Windows, Android, iOS, and macOS. One of the most popular game developing platforms is Unity, and C sharp is one of the more common programming languages used on that platform. So I'm sure you want to visualize some games that are made with C sharp. Some of them include Shadowrun Returns, Rust, Wasteland 2, and Hearthstone. Hearthstone? I don't know if I'm saying that right. I'm not a huge gamer. Okay, another area where C sharp is commonly used is in anti-hacking software. Now, in a world that there is so much put around cybersecurity and anti-hacking software, C sharp is more and more in demand because it is being used in that sector. And not to mention, it helps build a ton of different mobile apps. Some that you may be familiar with include Slack, Pinterest, Tableau, the World Bank, Fox Sports, just to name a few. So if your next question is, where do I learn C sharp? I'm not going to give one specific resource because there are so many online that it varies based on your past experience with programming languages. For me overall, I really like to use Udemy though. YouTube has some great tutorials, and where else do I like to do? Free Code Camp. I'll link some links down for each programming language that we cover today for some examples of courses on each language.
Okay, coming in at number four is C++. A little fun fact about C++ is that it was actually called, the first name of it was called the New C. The New C. I think I kind of like that.
C++ was developed by Bjarne Straustrup, I'm sorry if I'm butchering that name, as an extension to the C language. And C++ gives programmers a high level of control over the control system resources and memory. So once again, you're probably asking the question, well, why should I learn or consider learning C++? Well, to start off with, it's one of the world's most popular programming languages, or else I guess it wouldn't be on this list. It can be found and used in both operating systems, graphical user interfaces, and embedded systems. So it's really, its use can be used for a lot of different areas in the tech sector. Not to mention, as we just spoke about C Sharp, if you know C Sharp or Java, C++ is another language that is pretty easy to pick up or switch between. That being said, as I mentioned before, if you have no experience, it doesn't mean you can't learn C++. It just might take a little bit more time. Okay, some of my favorite applications are actually written with C++, so I want to talk about them, starting with Adobe Photoshop and Illustrator. So Photoshop is obviously one of the most popular and advanced graphic editors out there. And this is an application that was pretty much changed the game in photo editing and is still one, in my opinion, one of the best applications to work with for photo editing. C++ was part of building Adobe Photoshop and Illustrator, and it's a really great example of what C++ can do, meaning it works very well with that type of advanced apps. It's extremely fast and able to perform very well even when it's managing a lot of data. Another application that is built with C++ is Spotify. This auto streaming app, the backend is written with C++, and once again, another great example of C++ and its power, managing all the data, enormous amount of data, I should add, and C++ makes it all possible. Okay, and the app that we are on, YouTube. YouTube was written with many different programming languages when I was reading about it, but the area that was built with C++ was the video processing part. And that obviously is one of the most important parts, and it was written all with C++. So I think after going through some of these more powerful apps, you really get the point that C++ is one of the most powerful programming languages out there. It is versatile and it's not going anywhere anytime soon. So if you are interested in picking up a new programming language, this is definitely one to consider. Okay, coming in at number three, no surprise here, is JavaScript, which is my favorite language. So we gotta really, really emphasize that one. Okay, here's a really fun fact about JavaScript that I even didn't know until I started Googling fun facts about JavaScript, which is you can actually use the semicolon. You know, many programming languages use a semicolon at the end of a statement. In JavaScript, you can use it also at the beginning. I haven't tried this out yet, so I'm gonna try this out after the video, so I'm really curious to see if it actually works, but according to the internet and many different sites, you can use the semicolon at the beginning, which is kind of mind-blowing. So we gotta go test that out. Test it out and comment if it works for you. JavaScript, I'm not gonna lie, is probably my favorite programming language. I know a lot of you will either love that or hate that, but I think the reality is it's my favorite because it was the first programming language I ever learned. So when you learn something, your initial learning, I feel like you get a little attached to it, or it's like your first love. And for me, that was JavaScript. I also really like it because you can write both the front end and back end with it. So it's a very versatile language. I can build different applications with it. I can build different websites with it. It's just, it's flexible, unlike me. So JavaScript allows you to set up dynamic and interactive content, animated graphics, and other complex features all on the web. Maybe in past years, I would say JavaScript is more of a client-side language in that it executes within the web browser. However, more and more, it's increasingly being used on the server side with runtime platforms such as Node.js and other frameworks. I love you, Node. Node's one of my favorites as well, by the way. 97% of the world's websites use JavaScript to some degree. I'm going to give a few examples, but I'm sure your mind can just go to pretty much any website you use and you can think that JavaScript is part of it. Some famous apps that are built using JavaScript include Netflix, Candy Crush, Facebook, Uber, LinkedIn, and so much more. You get the point. It's extremely widely used, and honestly, it's a pretty friendly language to pick up. It has its quirks, so I'll say that, but from someone who learned it, there is our first programming language, I think it's a really good language to pick up first.
Okay, coming in at number two is Java. Fun fact about Java, actually, is it was actually originally called Oak. I'm curious to know if you knew that or not. If you did, leave down in the comments. This name was originally done by, let me see who it was done by, James Gosling, who was a developer, and he literally took inspiration from the oak tree outside of his office. Later, it was changed to Java by other developers.
This is a fun fact about Java that I didn't really know, actually, and it's also one of the most popular, or is the most popular language for IoT devices, so Internet of Things devices. And that's pretty cool because, as we just recently spoke about in one of our other videos, will smart devices become a thing of the past?
IoT touches everything and it's continuing and continuing to grow. So the demand for Java as a programming language, I truly believe will continue to grow, although it's still huge and massive right now. According to some people online, specifically coding nomads, Java is considered harder to learn than Python, but easier than C or C++. So it's kind of in the middle there. On the plus side though, once you master something like Java, learning something such as Python or even JavaScript will seem much easier. So it's kind of like you start out hard and then the other ones are easier. Some applications that are built with Java, or at least part of them are built with Java, include Spotify, Twitter, Cash App, Signal, and so much more. So you'll kind of start seeing that the apps I'm referring to, because I'm speaking about some of the more popular apps that we are all familiar with, you'll see kind of an overlap. For example, another app that is built with Java includes Netflix, and we just spoke about how JavaScript was built part of Netflix as well. So it's really important to recognize and keep in mind that a lot of these bigger applications or massive applications, they're definitely not just built with one programming language. A lot of times there's one programming language used for the front, one for the back, or maybe even multiple.
Okay, coming at number one, we have Python. No surprise here, and we're gonna speak about it just in a second here. But first, a fun fact. Did you know Python wasn't actually named after the snake? But actually, the creator of Python was a huge fan of the TV or the comedy TV show Monty Python, hence Python.
Okay, I'm sure there's no surprise here that I listed Python as number one programming language in demand based on LinkedIn's most top or the top programming languages for job postings. Python has been getting so much attention, I would say, the past two and three years maybe. Past 2 years for sure. It's been around longer than that, but it's been getting a lot of attention recently. And there's a lot of reasons why. One of the main ones being Python is easy to pick up. And now, when I say easy to pick up, if it's your first programming language, don't get mad at me and be like, Tiff, you said this was easy, I'm still not figuring it out. It still takes time to kind of master it, but it definitely is one of the easier or easy, let's say easier, programming languages to pick up. And I think another reason that Python is so popular is because it can be used for so many different things. So it's a general purpose server-side language. Python is used from tasks such as simple scripting to advanced web applications and artificial intelligence. So it really can be used for so many different things, from data science to building applications to, you know, artificial intelligence, that once you learn Python, it's like the world is your oyster. Actually, fun fact about Python, when I'm searching different applications that it has helped build, is Python is recognized as the official language at Google. So it's one of the key languages at Google today, which is pretty interesting, alongside C++ and Java. So that's pretty cool. And of course, it builds a ton of other apps or part of apps such as Spotify, Netflix, Uber, Dropbox, Pinterest. We've listed a lot of these before because it's just these massive companies are not just going to use one programming language, but it's really cool to see that they are using pretty much all on the list to some degree, or different ones are to different degrees, meaning you're pretty safe to learn any of these programming languages, that it is in demand.
Okay, let's talk candidly here though. Do you really need to worry about what programming language you learn first or the next programming language you learn? I think at the end of the day, it's one of our biggest challenges that we have to overcome is not getting so caught up in the mundane things. Yes, learning a popular programming language that is in demand is super important, especially if you want to level up your job or get a new job. However, don't let the fear of choosing the right programming language actually stop you from going after what you want, from learning how to code, from growing your skills. I remember when I first learned how to code, I would switch between so many different programming languages because I was scared I wasn't learning the right one. And I really wanted to highlight that, because don't let that fear or that uncertainty of not picking the right language stop you. Even if you learn Java, but then the job posting is requiring for JavaScript, they're not going to not choose you just because you don't know the right programming language. If it's a good company, they will have an understanding that you know a different programming language, and because of that, you have those skill sets that you can learn a programming language, they know you can easily probably pick up another one. So don't get too caught up on that. At the end of the day, throughout our career as programmers, as software developers, we will have to learn many different languages typically, and one of the biggest challenges is, once again, just being comfortable with that, although it can feel very uncomfortable. Okay, I'm gonna end this video here. I hope this was very insightful and helpful for anyone who is looking at what the top programming languages are for 2022. If you haven't already, make sure to hit that subscribe button for more tech and coding related videos. Shout out to some of these subscribers here. Thank you for all your support, your feedback, your questions, just being such a wonderful community. If you haven't already, give this video a thumbs up, and I will see you all soon. Thanks, everyone.